Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon you all. We have reached juz number 22, the 22nd portion of the Quran, and I want to cover three verses that is in the chapter of Fatir, verse number 15, 16, and 17. And these verses are pertaining to the greatness of your Maker. It's pertaining to the qualities that He possesses, particularly the quality of self-sufficiency. Now, those of us that believe in a deity, we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of the heavens and the earth, is not in need of anyone or anything. As a matter of fact, He created us to ensure that when we come closer to our purpose in life, it's to express that need in Al-Ghani Al-Hameed. It's to express that need in the self-sufficient, the one that is praiseworthy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in verse number 15 in the chapter of Fatir, after أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الناس أنتم الفقراء إلى الله والله غني حميد. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O mankind, all of you are impoverished to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah is the self-sufficient, the praiseworthy. When we look at this and we see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioning a reality of us as human beings, that أنتم الفقراء إلى الله, that you are impoverished to Allah, meaning that you will always be in need of your Maker. Whether you know it, acknowledge it, accept it, attempt it or not, that you will always be in need of your Maker. You will always be in need of the one that has control over you. Whether you accept and realize that He has ultimate control over you. One of the ways to realize that He has ultimate control over you is that you don't have ultimate control over yourself. Ultimate control over yourself. Just think about it. What are certain things in your body that you wish you could alter, you wish you could take away, you wish you could take back, you wish you could refine, you wish you could replenish within yourself? Physically, mentally, and most important, spiritually. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in ultimate control. There is a small window of responsibility that you have, and that's of the effort that you have to make. But in totality, in reality, ultimately, you are faqir, and faqir means poor. It means that the poor person is in need of something to enrich them. And that with our soul is what we need, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need our Maker ultimately, and that's why one becomes spiritual, that the term that they like to use. But particularly that spirituality is actualized by turning to the deity, first knowing who He is, and then turning to Him voluntarily. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala concludes and says, Wallahu ghaniyun hamid. Al-ghani is the self-sufficient, the one that is replenished and doesn't need replenishing, the one that suffices internally, intrinsically by himself and doesn't need any external object or thing or anything in existence to make him full or whole. Everything other than Him needs something outside of its physical self in order to be replenished, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And with that reality of self-sufficiency, He deserves praise. Therefore, He is Al-Hamid. So the fact that you as a form of creation, a human being that has a faculty of choice, you are always in need of the one who is self-sufficient. And because of that self-sufficient, He's praiseworthy. He deserves all praise. This is why we say, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. The next time you say Alhamdu, think of the fact that you're in need of Allah. Think of the fact that you're in need of your Maker to make things easy for you. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the next verse, إِن يَشَأْ يُذْهِبُكُمْ وَيَأْتِ بِخَلْقٍ جَدِيدٍ. If He wills, He could obliterate all of you from this existence and come with a new form of creation, or come with a new group of people, or come with a new person, or whatever the case may be. He has total authority because He is Al-Khaliq. He is the creator as well. So if He wills, He could do this easily. And we see how this is manifest. We see that with the coronavirus, there's many different ways that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can choose to take the life of someone or take someone out of their existence. And then Allah concludes by saying, وَمَا ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ بِعَزِيزٍ. Do not think that this process of taking away a nation of people, as He has done with the people of, you know, Sodom and Gomorrah, as he has done with many of the people of the prophets of their nations. Do not think that this is something that is difficult or something that is bearing on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The reality of things being difficult, the reality of making an effort, and when you exert power and all of this physics and science of things that will result in when power is generated, that may cause a form of exhaustion. This reality is not even within Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's reality, because Allah created all of this reality. Therefore, when realizing the reality of self-sufficiency in it and of himself, everything that comes after it is an explanation, being that he can take you away just as he has brought you here. And with that being a reality, we know that it is not difficult for Allah. It is not any type of stress for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In conclusion, seeing these beautiful verses, it allows us to realize the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the perfection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the perfection of what he brings, being the Sharia, being the law-abiding system of Islam that he has brought for us in order to make us the best version of ourselves. So realizing the greatness, self-sufficiency of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should increase us in our praise of him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of the fuqara. May he make us of those that increase our need to him and actualize that within our speech, our actions, and most importantly, within our hearts. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thank you.